Hello and welcome to Shine Be Fine Art. Today I am working with watercolors, and like in the last couple of videos, I am working on a painting for my series Buddha and the Bird. And like I had described, this is something related to Buddhism and Buddhist philosophies rather than the religion. And I'd add more in the video description about the concept behind this painting. And I'm working on the same concept, different mediums. So without much ado, let's get started. I have masked around the face and the body of the bird with masking fluid so that I could be really, really messy with my background and add as much water as possible as I wanted to, and not worry about paint getting inside the body of the bird or the face of Buddha. So as you can see, I'm working upright, and when you are working upright, you generally have to be very, very careful about how much water you are using, because the water due to gravity will tend to run down, and so will your paint, and it could ruin the whole effect. But my goal in this background was to get very messy, very blurry, not anything specific, so it worked totally with a lot of water and a little bit of paint, and you know, varying just random shades of green, yellow, blue and browns all over the background. And I could have done it with any shades of colors, but I chose these particular shades. Now moving on to the face of the Buddha, I am blocking the whole face gently with a sublime gray, which has more white than blue and black. And this particular painting, the face and the body of the bird, has to be done in multiple layers to get to where I want it to be. Now I am adding a little bit of shading in the face of the Buddha, and I'm following a reference photo from Pixabay, which I always recommend as a great resource for free and free definitely photos, and they are also usable, as in like it is royalty free. So as I am going on, I am adding shadows, and my goal here is to work with the contrast, because it is just a simple monochromatic face with various shades of gray, so I have to work a lot on my contrasts and lights and darks and the values in order to give it the real good sharp look. Although saying that I want a sharp look, I also have to mention that since the bird is the one subject that is closest to me, the face has got to be a little bit less colorful, less prominent than the bird, just so that you know the layering can work from backward to forward. Now you can see that I'm keeping on building the contrast and adding on more shadows with darker shades of gray. And for the gray, I have mixed blue, black and white from the beginning to the end. Sometimes I've added more blue than black, sometimes I've added more black than blue, sometimes I've added very little white and mostly blue and gray. And that is how I varied the different shades and gotten the different tones. Whenever you see that I'm working on with this eraser, I am actually rubbing off the masking fluid, which you have seen once or twice before as well. And once I took off the masking fluid, I will take a damp brush and just smudge the edges so that there are no harsh edges. Although for certain highlights, I'm leaving some harsh edges as well for the brightest whites, like you would see in the crown of Buddha's face. Elsewhere, I will smudge that harsh line. Keeping on with adding more and more detail up in the sculpture phase, the stone phase, and also adding more color to make it sharper, to make the contrast more and more prominent. It is all about contrast and values as far as the face of Buddha is concerned in this painting. Working still on the details, and this particular phase had a lot of details which I love to play with and slowly built on, and although it is not as easy to do layers on watercolor as it probably would be on acrylics and oil, because once the layer dries it is permanent, and that is not the case in watercolor. If I scrub too hard, then obviously the bottom layers, no matter how dry they were, can come off. But it is still workable, and building layers is how you get, you know, darks and lights and nice shadows and sharp contrast. It definitely cannot be done in just one go. It has to be done in multiple layers. And of late, since I've been again working with watercolors more often than before, I've been loving to do this layering with watercolors as much as I love doing it with oils or acrylics. I am almost close to the end of the face, and so I'm just sharpening the details. Now with my detail brush, I'm adding some cracks on the face just to make it more visually understandable that this is a sculpture and not like a face. Now coming to the body of the bird, I am just loosely blocking in some color, and this is also based off a reference photo of a hummingbird from Pixabay. So you can see that I have really used my Pixabay account this time, and I recommend it highly for reference, free, very good quality photos for all your works. So again, I'm blocking in colors, and for the body of the bird, apart from grays and browns, I have added yellow and green, and I have also used some cerulean blue for the bright blue areas. Now, I had a little bit trouble initially to get on the details on the bird and the right colors, but I kept on working with my layers like I always do, and it slowly started working out. Now I'm adding a little bit brighter colors and adding shadows on the wings of the bird. Eventually, where this painting ended, the only drawback I would see is I could not get the wings to be as bright as I wanted to. Somehow my red wouldn't pop out as much. I guess I need to add a different red to my portfolio of reds. Maybe that is the case, or maybe I was doing something wrong. I couldn't really figure that out till the end, but just kept on adding details more and more closely, very closely following the reference picture. And for the feathers, going little bit at a time, adding details and layers instead of going for one go. I never go for one go anyways, you must know by now. I love playing with layers and working in layers. Again, adding some more detail to the front wing. This is almost the last part of the painting, so I left this wing till the end, because this kind of has to pop out in order to the painting to work. And now I'm coming back with the white India ink to bring out some of the whites that are lost in the process of painting, but I thought that white highlight would definitely make a difference, and it did. So if you work with watercolors, apart from opaque titanium white and opaque gouache, you can also use India inks to get your bright highlights. and it is permanent unlike watercolor, so be a little bit more careful than you would be with your watercolor. Anyways, in watercolors you are a lot more careful. And there we come to the end of the painting. Thank you for watching.